I had walked down a road, a road full of memories, on a journey back to visit childhood friends. And I stopped at a gate that led into a schoolyard. Long forgotten feelings come to me again. The silence that stares from the dirty, dusty windows, broken only by the babble of a stream. And I feel as though I'm watched by a thousand different faces as I recollect a thousand different names. Now the old schoolyard is wild and overgrown. All the fences I had crossed are broken down. And I've learned many things, some of them best forgotten, since the last time that I stood upon that ground. Close my eyes, can't hold back the memories, childhood voices calling out to me. From deep inside, I see one of the faces looking at the man that he turned out to be. Now the old schoolyard is wild and overgrown. All the fences I had crossed are broken down. And I've learned many things, some of them best forgotten, since the last time that I stood upon that ground. Oh, the old schoolyard is wild and overgrown.
Is Well, I say I was from New Age of Teaching, and But they're worth every penny. For £4.50, I paid for 20 of them. The RE program has changed many times since, but Jesus, Marcus, and Paragus will always remain the same. I used the pictures throughout my teaching career, and now Mark and Kathy use them. Next, I need some way of explaining to the children about tens and units. So I enlisted the help of my then friend Michael to make this tens and units box. Anyone who has had me for their teacher will remember tying little bumps of sticks and pens to make different numbers. Before this, it was sit down and treat and carry the bump, which I could never understand. Again, when it came to Christmas, I got this simple little prep made. And it too has stood the test of time, now sitting on the top of our oil tank in the shed. Every Christmas, the children decorate the roof with cottonwood and frosted snowflakes. That year, 1960, I bought 21 figures for the crib for 21 shillings in the hair shop. Those burgers were made for rubber, so the children could handle them without any fear of breaking them if they dropped. I can tell you that in later years, our own children with toy guns shot them many times, and still here they are today. I have never seen rubber figures like this since. Other Christmas decorations then were made from newspaper paper. Back then it was a service for day work. So in 2 afternoons a week, I took all the girls. That year, the juniors made brindle skirts, trim for grad grading, and the seniors who were less than 12 cut out pajamas from a pattern. So there was flat seams, stretch seams, buttonholes, and 7-inch sleeves. I often wonder how many of them finished. Knitting was around in a wee bunny hole, right in big tree. I covered the bed with a wee I never did chance turning the wheel of a sock. Well, I talk along to Mr. Jack Woods, a real gentleman and scholar. And his salary was
where I was. children all came in. I didn't know any of the mommies or the daddies or the uncles or the aunties. So, anyhow, I said to them, I explained this to them. I said, my children, I'm delighted to see you. I'm your teacher. But I don't know anybody here. Little hand goes up. Please, ma'am. I know you. Well, my mammy ran up to the top Wendy to take this morning to have a good look at you. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I'll be very brief and just reiterate again my thanks to you all. I had a lovely time when I started here in 6 Mile Cross. God bless you.
Thank you. the photographs, world photographs of the year for 2009. And the third prize went to a photographer from Sweden. And he took four horrific photographs of somewhere in the Eastern Europe, where a man's face, stoned to death. And it shows you in the desert where they dug a hole and put a pure cricket into the hole. And all the men and women in the village had to buy the ears of bigamists. Be careful. they fired stones and up on his head only. And then the body seemed to go to the ground and took four photographs. Now, while I was watching that, I was saying, "What do I have to go on Friday night to the boss?"
Part of it was hell of a change from running up to Augnaglea school. want to say hello to my two sisters back here. And I was the last of, what, nine at the time? And I think after the school experience, my brothers were making me and they were crazy. You know, I got out of town. So I out of the United States. But it was like around 19, I think it was July 7th, 1960. And coming back here today, there's a big difference in the 6 months for us in the past few years. Next, recent years, it's improved a lot. So it's great to see the whole community here together and everything working.
Going round, 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 down, up, pedals, down, up, down, but I gotta get around. leader of the band. Follow me, I'm the leader of the band. Follow me.
Some of them bad.